Welcome back to SCS. In today's video, we're going to evaluate the sum and difference formulas for the sine function and the cosine function. Here in this problem, we're given a couple of things. First, we know that the cosecant of alpha is equal to 5/3, and we know the cosine of beta is equal to 8/17, and we're also told that alpha and beta are in a quadrant 1. So the first thing we need to do is create the special triangles that are true for alpha and beta. Let's begin by constructing a special triangle here for alpha. This is my right triangle. This here is angle alpha. I know that for cosecant, its relationship is the hypotenuse, which will be the 5, over the opposite side. In this case, that's going to be 3. And we need to figure out what this adjacent side is for alpha. You should recognize that it's a special triangle, so you should know this is 4. But if you didn't, you'd end up using the Pythagorean theorem. So we take 3 squared, and I'm going to add that to x squared. I'm going to call this down here x. Down plus x squared is equal to the hypotenuse squared. In this case, the hypotenuse is 5, so I square it. So I end up with 9 plus x squared is equal to 25. Then I end up subtracting 9 from both sides. So now I have x squared is equal to 25 minus 9, which will give me 16. And when I take the square root of both sides, I see that x is equal to 4, and that's what we have in place. Now let's create the special triangle for cosine beta. All right, this here is angle beta, and we know that cosine's relationship is the adjacent side over the hypotenuse. In this case, the adjacent side is 8, and the hypotenuse is 17, and we need to figure out this side, and I'm going to call that side there y. So here we have 8 squared plus y squared is equal to 17 squared. Well, 8 squared is 64, plus y squared, and 17 squared actually comes out to be 289. I'm going to end up subtracting 64 from both sides, so I see that y squared is equal to 225, and when you take the square root of both sides, we see that y comes out to be 15. So now we have our two completed special triangles, and now let's work on part A here. Let's switch colors to keep everything separate. Well, to work with A, we have the sine of the alpha plus beta. So we're going to fall to our sum formula for sine. And in this case, that sum formula turns out to be sine alpha cosine beta plus cosine alpha and sine beta. And now that we've got the special triangles, we're able to figure out sine and cosine for each one of these angles. So let's begin with sine alpha. When we look at alpha, we know that the relationship for sine is the opposite over the hypotenuse. So this first value is going to be 3/5. And we need to multiply that by the second value. This time we're looking at the angle beta, and we want cosine. Well, cosine is going to be the adjacent side over the hypotenuse, so that's going to be 8 over 17. Then I need to add this to the cosine of alpha. Well, here's alpha, the cosine. It's going to be the adjacent side, which is 4 over the hypotenuse, 5. So this here is 4/5. And now I need to take the sine of beta. Well, the sine is going to be the opposite over hypotenuse, so that's going to be 15 over 17. Now at this point, I just multiply and evaluate. Here I have 3 times 8, that's going to give me 24. And I'm just going to keep my denominator as it is for right now. So it's 5 times 17 plus, and here I'm going to multiply my numerators, 4 times 15, well, that's going to actually end up giving me 60. And then again, my denominator is going to be the 5 times 17. And now I've got 24 plus 60, and that turns out to be 84. And when I multiply 5 times 17, that becomes 85. So my answer here is 84/85, and this here is for part A. Now let's continue and work on part B. And again, let me switch colors to keep everything separate. For part B, you see I'm going to use a cosine, and it's a difference, so I'm going to use the difference formula for cosine. So here this is going to turn out to be cosine alpha cosine beta, and I'm going to add sine alpha sine beta. And again, I'm going to fall back to these special triangles. cosine of alpha. Actually, we've already found cosine alpha to be 4/5, so we'll just reuse that. Cosine beta, we found cosine beta to be 8/17, so let's put that in place. Plus the sine of alpha, again we found that to be 3/5, and we need to multiply that by the sine of beta, and we found the sine of beta to be 15/17. And of course we could have went back to the special triangles, but we've already done it, so I'm just reusing some of that work. And we're just going to multiply these fractions and then do some simplification if we can. Alright, first we're going to do multiply the numerators, so 4 times 8 to give me 32, and then I keep my denominator of 5 times 17 plus, let's keep this denominator again, 5 times 17, and then let's multiply our numerators, so 3 times 15 to give me 45. Now let's add the numerators. This 5 and 2 gives me a 7, and this 4 and 3 also gives me a 7, so my numerator here is 77. Now let's rewrite the denominator, and with the denominator I have 5 times 17, and when I rewrite I've got 77, and when I multiply 5 times 17 I end up with 85. So my answer for part B is 77/85. Alright, that sums up this video by Spello Tutorial Services. Please friend us on our Facebook page and also subscribe to that YouTube channel. And as always, thank you for watching.